Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be discussing about fog computing. See, fog computing, that is extension of cloud computing. There are some advancements that we are adding along with cloud computing, which is fog computing. In this video, I'll explain you fog computing in complete details, right? So let me explain you first, what is the meaning of fog computing? See, it is extension of cloud computing. Here we are having end devices. These end devices are accessing this cloud, right? So these end devices that can access applications as well as data from the cloud. But before it access data from the cloud, there is fog node in between. So here, these end devices will be accessing cloud through this fog node. This fog node will be providing edge to the access of data. What kind of edge? See, this end devices is assigned with fog node. So here, there is dedicated fog node for each end devices. So access speed of data with this end device that will increase. So in real-time application, latency will be very less with this end device when this end device is accessing data or application from this cloud. So here, frequently accessed data that will be there with this fog node. That's why this end device can access those data very fast, right? So that is how edge is there with fog computing. This name is there as per fog computing because of we are having fog nodes over here when end devices are accessing data from the cloud. So let me define fog computing. See, fog computing is the term coined by CISCO that refers to extending cloud computing to an edge of enterprise network. So here, these end devices will be accessing cloud through this fog node, right? And with this fog node, there will be frequently accessed data, right? So this fog node is providing edge to the extension of cloud, right? So as we are having fog nodes over here, it is also referred as fogging, and that is also referred as edge computing. The reason is all end devices are having edge over here before it accesses the data. What is the edge? Here latency is very less. So for real-time applications, fog computing that we used to prefer. Now how many parameters that is there with fog computing? See, it facilitates the operation of computing, storage, and network services between end devices and computing data center. So here we are having computing data center. These end devices are accessing this data with the use of fog node. So frequently accessed data that will be there with this fog node, and the data which we are not using frequently, that will be stored over here in this cloud, right? So as and when that data is required at that time, through this fog node, this end device that will be accessing that data which are there on cloud. So the data which we are not accessing so frequently, that will be having bit more latency, but frequently accessed data that we will be using through this fog node, right? Now let me discuss about basics of fog computing. See, the device comprising the fog infrastructure are known as fog nodes. So here each devices will be having fog nodes, or you can say fog cloud. So that fog cloud that will be having frequently accessed data. That's why latency will be very less, right? Here, in fog computing, all the storage capabilities, computational capabilities, and data along with applications are placed between the cloud and physical host. So here, with fog node, we are having some cloud infrastructure, that is fog cloud. So through fog cloud, each end devices will be accessing data, right? So computational capabilities are a bit faster over here, and latency will be less. If you access data directly from the cloud, in that case, that data access speed that will decrease. The reason is distance will increase. And here with end device, if dedicated small fog node is there, then that computational capabilities that will increase, and here speed will be more over here, as well as you will be resolving some issues of privacy, right? If everything is there on cloud, then privacy issue will be there. But if it is there with fog node, then communication is happening in between end device and fog node. So security concern that even we are resolving up to some extent, right? See, all these functionalities are placed more towards the host. See here, that fog node that is very nearer to end device. That's why you can say these functionalities are placed more towards the host, right? This makes processing faster, as it is done almost at the place where data is created. So you can say end device that is very nearer to fog node. That's why that access of data that will be very fast over here, right? See, it improves efficiency of the system and it also ensures increased security. Why it ensures increased security? The reason is all the data that is not accessed from the cloud, frequently accessed data that is accessed from the fog node, and least used data that end node will be accessing from the cloud, right? So here security concern that is bit less over here. The reason is security is provided at the end of fog node over here, right? Now let me discuss about when to use fog computing. So see, there are some scenarios that you need to understand. See, it is used when only selected data is required to send to the cloud. So here selected data that we are sending on the cloud, right? This selected data is chosen for long-term storage and is less frequently accessed by the host. So as and when you have some selected data which we are not using frequently, that we will be storing on the cloud, but recently accessed data that will be there in fog node, right? See, it is used when the data should be analyzed within the fraction of second, means for lower latency application we are using it. Like if you have emergency system, right? If some patient is there in hospital and that patient scenario is critical, in that situation you need to have lower latency. In that situation one should be using it, right? It is used whenever a large number of services needs to be provided over a large area at different geographical location. So as if large service is required at varieties of locations at a time, it is very essential. The reason is here speed is the concern, right? So for real-time application and for larger geographical area, this is preferable. See, if you have single cloud for larger area, then latency will be more. But if you have larger area with single cloud along with small fog clouds, in that case for real-time application this will be preferable, right? See, devices that are subjected to rigorous computation and processing must use fog computing. So if you have rigorous computation and if you need to have lower latency and if you need to process the data very fast, in that situation fog computing, that is compulsory, that one can say, in terms of cloud computing. See, real world examples where fog computing is used are IoT devices like car to car consortium in Europe, devices with sensors, cameras for IoT industrial internet of things, right? So these are the real time examples, right? So one can say, as if you have lower latency requirement or for real time application, we should be using fog computing instead of cloud computing. Now I'll be going to explain you advantages of fog computing. So here, see, with the use of fog computing, we will be reducing amount of data that needs to be sent to the cloud. The reason is we are not sending all the data on the cloud. We are accessing data from the fog cloud, right? So the data which we are less frequently used, that is only we are sending on the cloud. Frequently accessed data that will be there in fog node over here, right? Or you can say fog cloud over here. Since the distance to be traveled by the data is reducing, it results in saving network bandwidth. See here, fog node or fog cloud, that is nearer to end device, right? So you will not be sending data on the cloud. So automatically you will be saving the bandwidth. The reason is the data which we are not using frequently, that is only the data which will be forwarding on the cloud, right? Frequently accessed data that will be there in fog cloud. That's why here you will be saving bandwidth, that you can say, right? See, it will be reducing response time. Why? The reason is fog cloud, that is very nearer to end device, right? So here latency will be very less, response time that will improve over here, right? That's why it is preferable for real-time applications. See, it improves the system's overall security as the data resides closest to the host. As I have told you, here we don't need to have any security concern. Why? The reason is fog cloud, that is very nearer to end device, and as it is very nearer to end device, here other people with larger distance cannot even observe it. If it is there on cloud, then hackers can hack those data even. But as data accessed from fog cloud, many people cannot even see those data. That's why security concerns are less over here with fog computing, right? See, it provides better privacy as industries can perform analysis on their data locally. Here, in general, you can say data access is happening locally. Why? The reason is fog cloud, that is very nearer to end device. right? Now, I'll be explaining you disadvantages of fog computing. See, when it comes to disadvantage, then you can say congestion may occur between host and fog node due to increase in traffic. So at particular location, if more traffic is there, then congestion may occur, right? The reason is if multiple end nodes are there at same location, then it is a bit difficult to provide fog node to all the users. In case of higher density of users, there can be congestion, right? See, power consumption that will increase when another layer is placed between host and cloud. Obviously, power consumption will increase. Why? The reason is here you will be adding another node itself, that is a fog cloud. So previously you have been having one device that was accessing cloud with cloud computing, but here we are adding additional node, that is fog node. That's why power consumption that will increase over here, right? See, scheduling tasks between host and fog nodes along with fog nodes and the cloud is difficult. See, here scheduling will be difficult as if density of people increases, right? But if density of users are less, or you can say density of end nodes are less, in that case this issue will not be there. But as I have told you, if number of people are increasing, then congestion will increase, and in case of congestion, scheduling of tasks, that is getting difficult over here, right? See, data management becomes tedious as along with the data stored and computed, the transmission of data involves encryption and decryption too, which in turn release the data. So here, see, data management that is become a bit tedious. Why? The reason is we are adding another layer, that is fog node, right? So we need to provide encryption and decryption. That becomes a bit tedious. The reason is we are adding one additional layer over here, right? So as I have told you, here we are adding some functionality. So if you add another node, then obviously you will have to provide functionality, right? So every time there will be encryption and decryption when data transmission is happening with fog node, right? So that task that is getting a bit tedious, but that is the functionality which we are adding. In cloud computing, we are not adding additional functionality, right? But here, as we are adding one additional functionality, you will have to manage all those things. So that is how disadvantages are there, right? Now I'll be explaining you applications. So this fog computing that can be used to monitor and analyze patient's condition in emergency case, right? So as I have told you, for real-time application, we should be using fog computing rather to go for cloud computing. See, it can be used for real-time monitoring as high-speed trains. We want as little latency as possible. So for high-speed train, we need to have lower latency. So for those kind of real-time applications, we should be using fog computing, right? In cloud computing, there will be bit delay, but in fog computing, delay will be very less, right? See, it can be used for gas and oil pipeline optimization. It generates huge amount of data and it is insufficient to store all data onto the cloud for analysis. So as if you have oil and gas pipeline optimization, then you need to have some real-time applications, right? The reason is continuously so many data are generated, and that analysis that has to get computed with lower latency. So for that type of situation, we should be using this, right? So that is how different applications are there. I hope you have understood this video. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.